In this video, I'll demonstrate how to add a quiz and configure its settings.
Now I'm ready to
add
start
the quiz
adding questions
activity.
into the quiz. In this video, I showed you how to add a quiz and configure its basic settings. You might want to consider duplicating this activity using the duplicate feature in Moodle before adding questions to it.
Under general settings, enter a name for the
quiz
and a description for your students with clear instructions for how to complete the quiz. Optionally, you can choose to display the description on the front page of the course, but I don't recommend this because your front page can become very cluttered looking. With the timing settings, you can set opened and closed times for quizzes. Enable this feature by clicking the checkbox for the settings you wish to use and selecting the appropriate dates. You can also add a time limit, control what happens when a student doesn't finish the attempt in time, and add a grace period. The next area to configure is grade. If you are using categories in your gradebook, then select a category here. If desired, you can set a passing grade. Make sure that you select the number of attempts and the aggregation method you will use for multiple attempts. The layout settings allow you to control how quiz questions display to students. Select when you want a new page to occur. When you add questions to a quiz, page breaks will automatically be inserted according to this setting. You can also choose a navigation method. If you choose sequential, then students are required to go through the quiz in order. Next, you can configure the question behavior settings. Determine if you want the answers and distractors to shuffle when displayed by selecting yes or no from the Shuffle Within Questions option. Next, select how you want the question to behave. It is critical that you select the correct option here. These options are covered in the course. The setting Each Attempt Builds on the Last allows you to display each new quiz attempt with the results of the previous attempt. If you want to use this option, then you'll need to allow for multiple attempts and set this option to yes. Next are the settings for review options. This area can seem a little overwhelming, but it is simple to set up. These options control the information users can see when they review a quiz attempt or look at the quiz reports. Check all items that you would like to include. The details of these options are covered in the course. If you aren't using a close date for the quiz, then don't even worry about the settings under after the quiz is closed. For the settings under later while the quiz is still open, I usually check everything except for the right answer. If you plan to use the overall feedback options, which we'll discuss later in this video, you'll want to leave this checked. Now, let's take a look at the appearance settings. If you would like, you can display the student's picture by setting the Show the User's Picture setting, large or small. You can select the number of decimal places you'd like to display for the quiz grade. Note that it is only to display. It doesn't actually affect the score stored in the database. I typically leave this set to 2. You can also change the number of decimal places for the question grades if you'd like. Lastly, you can decide if you would like to display blocks during the quiz attempt, but I always set this to no to limit distractions. The next area that we will discuss is the extra restrictions on attempts. You can enter a password into the Require Password field if you want a student to have to enter it before being able to take the quiz. The Require Network Address setting allows you to specify a partial or full IP address to limit that only students in a certain location can access the quiz. You may also force delays between the first and second attempts and between later attempts by enabling these options, and then entering the number of minutes. Lastly, you can choose to enable browser security by selecting Full Screen Pop-up with some JavaScript security. This will force the quiz to open in a full screen pop-up window, which will cover all other windows with no navigation controls.
The next area that you may configure is overall feedback. This area allows you to enter text to display to the student after they finish a quiz attempt. This text can vary depending on the grade that the student earned. If you'd like to use this, just fill in the feedback text area with your overall feedback. If you would like to enter further feedback options, enter another grade boundary and the corresponding feedback. I don't use this area because I like to use the Personalized Learning Designer.
Like other activities, you can set the activity completion settings.
I always set the completion tracking to be graded in order to be tracked as complete. The last step is to click the Save and Display button. Now I'm ready to start adding questions into the quiz. In this video, I showed you how to add a quiz and configure its basic settings. You might want to consider duplicating this activity using the Duplicate feature in Moodle before adding questions to it. This will save you time from having to set these settings for each quiz activity that you add into your course.